Hello everyone, welcome to the very first portfolio review in Critique Corner. If you're brand new here, welcome. I'm so excited that you're here. This playlist is all about reviewing different user-submitted portfolios and hopefully leaving them feeling super empowered to create some work that they're very excited about. In today's video, we are going to be doing a review of the lovely Hillery Powers. So I'm just gonna go ahead, pull up her website, and we're gonna go through her portfolio, talk about what's good, what she could do better, all that good stuff. So let's just hop right into it. Here we have Hillery Powers' beautiful website. It's her online portfolio. Hillery is a hand lettering artist, and she's best known for her brush style lettering, which I really love. So as I continue going through this review of her work, I'm going to break it up into a couple different sections. I first want to talk about content, then I am going to be talking about color, then technique, then compositions. With each category, I'm going to talk about what she's doing really well, what I like, and then ways that I think that her work could be better as a whole. We are going to be going through her portfolio in general, not one piece specifically. So I'm going to really keep that in mind as I go through this review. Okay, so let's start off with the content. Overall, I feel like the overarching story that she has behind her work is really about empowering local brands and communities. She has a lot of work for what seems like Orlando, doing different events, doing murals for different events like that. Her work feels very fun to me, edgy. It's like fun and playful. It seems like her work that reflects a sense of education in the arts. I'm guessing she's probably had some sort of background in education, whether she took a traditional sign painting class or something like that. It really seems like her work is inspired by, you know, traditional sign painting, and she's had some sort of education in that. Okay, so what I would absolutely love to see more of, or pushed further in her portfolio. So I would totally love to see her do more pop-up events and murals. I think that all of the work that she has from those sorts of events is really strong. And I think that if she partnered more with brands that are like really fun and edgy and well-educated, I think that that side of her work would really start to sing. It's also highly marketable, and it's fun to create. So I think Hillery would enjoy doing more work like that. I know ad agencies would hire her in an instant to do on-site work like sign painting or murals or stuff like that. So I would love to see more of that in her portfolio. So what I'd like to see less of, so there are a couple pieces in here. Like this Love Orlando piece, I feel like it is good, but if it were my portfolio, personally, I'd take that piece out. I feel like it kind of clashes with the overarching story of what she has going on. The technique seems a little bit different, whereas I'm loving all of that brush technique, which I'll talk about here in a minute. But this one just to me personally seems a little bit unintentional when it's plopped in here amongst all of these other pieces that really feel like they go together quite well. Okay, color. So what I would love to see more of, I'd love to see more of these bright colors and kind of like the gradient fades that she has going on. The bright and poppy colors, including, you know, just simply black and white, can really push that idea that I was talking about, which, you know, I feel like is her why, you know, just pushing edgy, fun, contemporary. It would be fun to see some more phrases that kind of push those ideas as well, maybe like a little bit quirky types of phrases. I would definitely enjoy seeing that in her work. And with pops of color, I just think it would be awesome. So what I'd like to see less of, I personally think that I'd like to see less of muted colors, kind of like the muted blue color. Unless it's paired with a bright pop of color. So like a muted blue would look really cool paired with like I don't know, like a fuchsia color or like super, super bright orange. I think that would still add to the overarching message that her entire portfolio is portraying. So it looks nice, but it doesn't really, those muted colors, they do look nice, but it doesn't really fit into the overall message, like I said. Okay, so let's move on to technique. Okay, what I would like to see more of, I absolutely would like to see more of the brush lettering sign painter style. I think, Hillary, you're getting really good at it. I'd love to see you get even better. You still have like a sense of whimsy to it, and I would like to see more of that. So keep practicing that. Keep putting that in your portfolio, especially since you have a lot of other work that is like that. I think it would just pair really well. Okay, what I would like to see less of. Again, I would like to see less of the styles that don't fit into your overarching message. That Love Orlando piece that I was talking about, I felt like the technique was just different. It felt unintentional paired amongst all the other images. So I would definitely like to see less of that. And I talk about this a lot on like my blog and, you know, my Instagram and different areas. I have no problem with artists creating multiple portfolios. So if that is, you know, a type of style that you really want to pursue or, you know, explore a little bit more, I think going and just really exploring it and then making it a series instead of just having one piece amongst a lot of other pieces that are totally different. It feels like an afterthought. Okay, compositions. What I would like to see more of. So I absolutely love the second piece. Okay, I absolutely love the second piece right here, with all of this lettering kind of stacked on top of each other and this very organic composition. I feel like you're doing that so well. It has so much personality. It actually, I think that I'm really drawn to this because I fall into this sort of category when it comes to like compositional leaning. I enjoy working with organic compositions that kind of have a moving baseline and they're whimsical. I love that composition paired with the gradient color and creating hierarchy in the piece by having certain words larger and just kind of stand out, and then using the little sparkles as a secondary element to create texture in the background. I think that is so fun, and it really lends to the style that you're working in. I also absolutely adore the commit and explore piece that you did. This piece is different than the other kind of brushed lettering sign painting type stuff that you did, but to me, it feels like it fits. I think it's like the combination of the colors paired with the other pieces that you did. Anyways, I digress. I enjoy the composition of this. It's a totally different type of composition compared to pretty much anything else on, I'm looking through here. And yeah, it's a, you know, a one of a kind in terms of composition on your portfolio board. And I would love to see more of that kind of pairing. Oh, here we go. The ORL and the FLA, that is awesome. It's really bringing, oh yeah, and established in 2005. That's really bringing in that brush style and making everything feel like it fits. And I love the minimal color. It's awesome. And that arc kind of with the straight bottom that anchors everything, and then creating a border around it to kind of pull everybody back into the piece. I just think it's beautiful. I love it. It's different than the other composition, totally different, but I would love to see more of that. Also, A Day to Remember, the big United States piece. I think that is really cool in the same aspect as that first one that I talked about. It's creating hierarchy with that push and pull of size of lettering, and then creating texture as like a secondary half tone, those little sparkles. I love it. And just fitting lettering into a shape like that, it takes a lot of skill. And so I think that if I were a client and I saw that, I would say, oh yeah, I want that on my wall. Or, you know, I could really see this at a college. Like if you went to a college and did a big mural, I think that's awesome. Let's see here. Okay, so what I would like to see less of in terms of composition. There's nothing that I would like to see less of. Something, again, that I would like to see more of, but I guess this is sort of the, you know, a little bit more negative side of things, is that I think that, but this isn't even a negative thing, it's a positive thing. I think that you're doing great with that very organic style of composition. I would love to just see you get better at it. So there are some pieces on here that I think are better than others. Like the first one that I pointed out is absolutely amazing. And then I feel like the Indie Folk Fest, That's really good too. I love that too. Let's see here. Which one was I looking at? Oh yeah, even the You Are a Brilliant, Strong, Beautiful, that piece, the fitting room mural, I feel like that one I'm not quite as fond of in terms of composition. I can see where you're going with it, but I feel like you could have filled up the negative spaces, you know, all throughout the composition a little bit better in the same way that you did with some of the other pieces that I think it looks so good. But I do love the colors. I love the lettering style on that one. It's just more so just, I feel like the composition could have been pushed a little bit further.
Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you so much, Hillary, for submitting your portfolio. It is so lovely, and I'm just thrilled to see where you go with your work, and I'm just really excited. So for anyone else who wants to have their portfolio reviewed, I'm gonna leave a link below where you can submit your work. And again, if you're brand new here, make sure you go ahead and subscribe to my channel, and also make sure to follow me on all of my social channels, at Molly Jacques on everything. So see you soon.